What are dark secrets about the porn industry that people should know? The dressing room trash cans are full of empty disposable enemas and it smells like farts and sadness in there. It smells like farts and sadness at my job too. Oh, a fellow dev I see. Working from home. A lot of the 18-year-olds in the porn industry probably were in it when they were younger too. From now, I will stick to 30-year-old secretary category. I know a girl who did some porn and she started doing it when she was only a teenager, except all her porn videos were labeled 18+. Edit, she started doing porn at 16 and they just lied and said she was 18+, in her videos even though she was underage. That's a child sex ring. One phone call to view the paperwork for that crap would destroy them and they'd be in jail. There's a whole business built around the record keeping of porn stars. The grooming and locking. If you've never heard of locking, it's basically when a group of girls doing porn are living together, typically, and they are pressured to spend their money by producers who claim to be their friends. The goal here is to diminish any sort of saving money thought process, and they make it out like the money will never stop coming. This keeps them broke and making doing more shoots. Edit, just wanted to say thanks for the upvotes. Hopefully this will be top comment so more awareness gets out. Grooming doesn't stop because they made a few videos. That was in the after porn documentaries on Netflix, weren't they? I think the doc was called Hot Girls Wanted if I remember correctly. A lot of actors takes a lot of drugs. Like a lot. Plus basically every male actor gets erectile dysfunction after being in the business for so long as they are pumped up on Viagra. Too much blow and the vagina won't grow. Too much white and your dick ain't right. Too much speed and your peen won't breed. Too much dust and your lust goes bust. Too much poppy and your bits go floppy. Too much thong and your schlong ain't strong. Too much dope and your dick says, nope. Too much crack and your nut crawls back. Too much powder and you can't shoot chowder. Too much coke and your wiener's broke. Oh, I also used to drive some exotic dancers 2 or 3 cities to do regular doctor appointments. They never felt safe going local because they always get recognized and people get creepy. Not sure if that counts as porn industry, but I'd imagine the same rules apply. Many of the 18-year-old porn stars were recruited when they were 16 or 17. I vacationed in San Diego when I was 17 and was recruited for modeling by a very attractive and seductive young woman at the beach. I went to the office building she told me to go to, a high-rise next to a highway. In reception I walked out. Casting couch type atmosphere and models as the staff. My story ends there. Sounds like you almost got Ghislaine Maxwell, Ed. Nah dog, she said she was 17. Too old for that crew. Damn, that's effed up. Do they film at 16 to 17 or is it just recruitment? As far as recording, it's almost always when they're 18, but I wouldn't doubt they practice beforehand. That's some creepy crap. In my state, it is legal to have sex with a 16-year-old if you are 23 or younger. The 16-year-old cannot give consent to a 24-year-old. And that was a somewhat recent change. It used to go up to age 26. But the 16-year-old cannot consent to nude pictures. Even if they directly take them and send them with no other pressure from anyone. And the 16-year-old is violating the law and can face charges for sending a consensual nude picture even if it was to another 16-year-old. But parents are usually lenient when the other person is the same age or within a year, so it never goes past a slap on the wrist. Also coincidentally, we used to be one of the top, if not the top, porn watching state in the US, Utah. All of this information would be up to date as of about a year or two ago, when I had to go through the court process as a 17-year-old, and I was required to learn these laws in order to get my charges dropped. Edit, I forgot to mention at 17 you can now hook up with up to a 24-year-old. And at 18 you can send and receive pictures from other 18-year-olds and hook up with anybody between 16 and at whatever age a person would be considered too old to give consent. But obviously that varies based on health conditions and mental capacity. Edit 2, I should also mention, it is taken on a case-by-case basis as well. In a situation like mine where I was 17 and she was 17, almost 18, I am younger than her, I get let off fairly easy and nothing will be on my permanent record. Because we were both minors, the severity of the charges are dramatically decreased. However, there have been a lot of cases where, say, a 19-year-old will sleep with a 17-year-old and that 19-year-old will still catch a statutory charge even though he is within the age range. In cases like that, there's probably a lot of other complicated underlying issues that are unseen to the people not directly involved in the relationship of those two people. Because for most people it's hearsay and don't understand that you also need to consider signs of manipulation or abuse which can be proven by phone records or eyewitnesses, and those factors weigh heavily on what the judge is going to decide. So it is likely your perfect 19-year-old brother who was just messing around with a minor and got some bullcrap charges was really being a manipulative piece of crap, but nobody wants to admit to that to their family. Edit 3, misinformation, since been corrected. A truth people don't want to accept. That 18-year-old porn star that made all that buzz 2 years ago didn't get all those high production shoots before she was halfway to 19 just after she turned 18, it's not possible. Also, all those waited for her 18th birthday videos are basically admitting to grooming minors. I got to be honest, I simply thought that all those supposed 18-year-olds weren't 18-year-olds at all and instead just young-looking older girls. That is sometimes the case, Riley Reed has been playing a teenager for a decade now. But it goes both ways. Didn't Lupe Fuentes have to go to court over this once? Irk, a man was facing child porn-related charges for viewing her videos purely because she's so petite and young-looking that the prosecution decided she couldn't possibly be 18, and she pretty much had to fly herself out to present proof of her age to the court. Edit, yeah, this happened. From Wikipedia, in 2009, federal agents arrested a man in Puerto Rico on suspicion of possessing child pornography that included Fuentes. At trial, a pediatrician testified that Lupe was underage based on her appearance. Lawyers for the defense subpoenaed her to show her passport, proving that she was 19 years old at the time of filming. Fuentes was born in 1987, and started in porn in 2007. Same, I thought it was about as honest as those losing her virginity for the first time on camera videos. Honestly, neither scenario would surprise me. Wait, you mean that roided out dude with a tribal tattoo wearing a lab coat who assured us she's a virgin isn't a real doctor? That some companies like Girls Do Porn systematically trick/coerce young women into porn, web link. I read both articles you sourced. There's a story in the story, I think this happens so much more than just this one company. Sad. But good article for education. Jesus F, the part that really ruined my day was the workplace rape. Somebody recognized her from a video and saw that as an invitation? Being in porn equals automatic consent, I guess. Hot Girls Wanted, produced by Rashida Jones, explores most of the seedy practices discussed in here. Seen it and can highly recommend it. Also its follow-up film. Edit. The follow-up film is actually a 6-part series, but it's very bingeable, so I forgot that it is not a movie. Hot Girls Wanted and Hot Girls Wanted, Turned On are both available on Netflix. That documentary broke my heart. Some of those girls are basically getting beat up on camera. I'll never forget watching True Life I'm a Porn Star on MTV. Probably 20 years ago. The girl was brand new to porn and it chronicled her start. She did her first gangbang and afterwards they interviewed her. She was crying and literally looked like she had been beaten up. Eyes and face swollen and red. It was disturbing. I think I remember that one as well. Her story was wild. That the same one that had the straight guy that was doing gay porn, but did that style because it paid crazy dollar? James Dean, the famous porn star who made a killing by looking like an authentic, genuine dude, is a rapist according to several co-stars and his ex-girlfriend Stoya. But the porn industry didn't get a Me Too movement, so he's still in porn and Stoya isn't. And it wasn't even a effing secret. Edit, Apparently she's still doing porn, just on her own platform at zerospace.com edit, two ex-girlfriends, web link. Kink.com dropped him though. They're actually a pretty good company from what I've seen and heard. I really like how their videos show the intro and discussion of consent and safe words before playing. Refreshing to see that. Well, yeah. I just feel like if you're going to be shooting that kind of porn and be a major brand, you need to cover every base. Otherwise, you're effed. The whole tons of Viagra thing is absolutely true, and so is the bit about casting directors playing fast and loose with STDs. I have a friend that once turned down a shoot for a gay porn at a campground because none of the actors were required to be tested beforehand. A few of them ended up contracting HIV from that shoot. You could tell all the guys during the late 90s, early 2000s were jacked up on steroids and Viagra. Eric Everhard is a great example. The guys were built like football players. They had tiny, shriveled up testicles from the roids, and their chests and faces were super red from Viagra. They all looked like they had sunburns on their chest, necks and face. That was a Viagra flush. Eric Everhard. LOL. Male porn names are a hidden gem of literary prowess. My favorite got to be Rod Rockhard. Brock Landers and Chest Rockwell. Dirk Diggler. Lance Hardwood, sex architect. Oh, that's why, I always thought that was weird. Aren't they supposed to take weekly or monthly STD checks? Source: My Memory of a Johnny Sins YouTube Vlog. Johnny Sins did make a video where he said that they had to get tested super regularly to make sure they didn't have STDs. But I'm assuming those are for the Warner Brothers and Universals of the porn industry. I'm sure the student films don't get half as much security in them. August Ames didn't want to shoot with a guy doing gay porn for the same reason. She was accused of homophobia by a bunch of buttholes on Twitter, harassed for days and killed herself. I went to high school with her, Mercedes at the time. My parents are still friends with her mom. That whole situation was devastating. That whole no means no thing flew out the window for some reason that I don't completely understand. When Jenna Jameson didn't want to work with black talent, it was everyone has their preferences, respect that. But when August didn't want to work with someone who engaged in high-risk behavior, it was kill the homophobe. Different times. Jenna Jameson today would be excoriated for such a preference. I thought her reasoning was that it was exploitative of black people. Most of the shoots with a black man and a white woman, at least at that time, were based on the Mandingo stereotype or a freak show element. Watch this white girl get destroyed by this black dick, etc. It would make me uncomfortable too. Things haven't really changed then, huh? Some girls are tricked into filming the video. They're promised to do some modeling, and when they arrive they find out that it's more than just a few pictures. Porn is a big human trafficking industry. Nowhere near as rampant and dangerous as child trafficking, but it's still very active. Came to comment from personal experience. I'm not in the adult entertainment industry, but I booked a boudoir photo shoot a few years back to surprise my boyfriend, and I booked with this amazing photographer. I was raped during the photo shoot. A video recorder was on the entire time that of course captured everything, and the video went to the black market. The photographer was actually deep into sex trafficking, but these traffic rings stay 100 steps ahead at all times, that the police investigation became cold very fast. God effing damn, I shed a tear for you. That is awful. I hope you got the help you need / needed. You kind soul. I have cried tears that could replenish the ocean. Trauma / PTSD is tolling. I was totally in denial the first 2 years, but this year, and I invested in my healing, so I'm getting better each day, Purple Heart. Good luck on your continued recovery. It feels wrong to upvote this, I am sorry for you. I hope you are better. I was not at all expecting this reaction, but damn, I wish I had turned to Reddit sooner, since the love and warmth I'm feeling is bringing tears of joy. Thank you, Purple Heart. Lots of stuff like that. Even when the women know they're showing up to shoot porn, they'll consent to one set of circumstances and show up on set only to be told they need to film an entirely different scene, typically one more uncomfortable or more dangerous than what the actress originally signed up for, but they showed up for a paycheck and oftentimes can't really leave without it. Porn isn't a how-to guide for your own sex life. Wait, you're telling me I shouldn't just unsuspectingly stick it in my sister's butt? You mean stepsister? The titles are always iffy with that. Those orgasms aren't real. Edit, I can't believe this was my first comment that got so many upvotes and an award. WTF. Next you'll be telling me my wife is faking it too. I don't know, she's pretty convincing. Slayed him. Does that mean they're not in love? Zero. How about the pizza? There was never a pizza in that box? Pizza is not coming? What about the sink? Is it not going to get fixed? What are those blokes ejaculating then? Stunt double dick. Stunt vagina. Thank you for watching. If you like our videos, please like them on YouTube. And share them with your friends. Please subscribe to be the first to know about Red Rabbit Reader's new videos. We welcome your comments below. Another of our videos will begin shortly.